friends, how are you all? I hope you all are fine at your home. Today we will see Math Magic Workbook Standard 3rd. Now all of you open your book, page number 159. Today we will see the problem sums. Okay, maintain, solve the problems. See, most of the students, whenever the words come problems, then they almost leave that sum. वो एग्जाम में छोड़ देते हैं. But it's not a hard one. It's a very easy. See, first of all, what you have to do? Read the questions properly. Okay. First one. There are 10 pencil in one box. One box में कितनी pencil है? 10 pencil. एक box में कितनी pencil है? 10 pencil. How many total pencils are there in 5 such boxes? See, again I will explaining you. एक box में 10 pencil है. वैसे कितने box है? 5 box में कितनी pencil होगी? How many total pencils are there in 5 such boxes? So, what you have to do? First of all, you have to write down. In one box, एक box में 10 pencil है, तो in one box, 10 pencils are there. Therefore, in 5 boxes, how many pencils are there? Is equal to 5 multiply by 10. Cross multiplication, okay? 5 multiply by 10. 5 tens are 50. 50 pencils. See, how many total pencils puchhe hain? How many means kitni pencil? Total kitni pencil? To, wo how many jagah pe aapko kya likhna hai? 50 pencils. Total 50 pencils are there in 5 such boxes. See, total 50 pencils are there in 5 such boxes. Pura questions mein se hi aapko likhna hai. Okay, so pura sums aap agar exam mein karoge to hi full marks milenge. Agar hum 5 multiply by 10 kar and 50 likh kar chhod de, to it's a half marks will we get. Okay, 2 marks का सम है और हमने इतना ही किया तो 1 marks ही मिलेंगे. ओके, सो पूरा आपको इस तरह लिखना है. नाउ सी द सेकंड वन. देयर आर 9 बेंचेस इन वन क्लासरूम. वन क्लासरूम के अंदर 9 बेंचेस आ दे. हाउ मेनी टोटल बेंचेस आर देयर इन 7 सच क्लासरूम. वैसे 7 क्लास में है, क्लास में कितनी बेंचेस होगी? सो राइट डाउन हियर. इन वन क्लासरूम 9 benches are there. Therefore, in 7 classroom, how many benches are there? Is equal to, again, 7 multiply by 9. 7 multiply by 9. 7 9s are 63. 63 what? Benches. How many total benches? No. So, 63 benches. Now see, there are 63 benches in a 7 classroom. See, how many total benches ki jagah pe aapko kya likhna hai? There are 63 benches in 7 classroom. Okay, now see the third one. There are 4 books in one stack. Ek stack hai, usme kitni books hai? 4 books. How many total books are there in 8 such stacks? वैसे 8 stacks है, उसमें कितनी books होगी? So write down here, in one stack, 4 books are there. Therefore, in 8 stack, how many books is are there? So 8 multiplied by 4. 8 fours are 32. 32 books. Now write the answer. There are 32 books in 8 stacks. Now see the fourth one. If one apple costs rupees 5. एक एप्पल का की प्राइस क्या है? रुपीस 5. Cost of one apple is equal to rupees 5. What will be the cost of 6 apples? The cost of 6 apple is equal to how much? Now see here. Cost of one apple is equal to rupees 5. Therefore, cost of 6 apples is equal to how much? 6 multiplied by 5. Okay. Is equal to 6 multiplied by 5. 6 5s are 30. 30 what? Aapko rupees puch hai. Cost puch hai. Cost means rupees. Toh wo 30 rupees aega. Okay. Cost of 6 apples. Okay. Is rupees 30. Now see the fifth one. If two chikus are given to one child. See, one child means एक child को, एक बच्चे को कितने chikus दिए हैं? Two chikus. Then how many chikus are needed to distribute among nine children? And children कितने हैं? Nine children. और nine children में से एक children को two chikus मिलते हैं. तो वैसे nine children के लिए हमें कितने chikus चाहिए? So this way you have to write down. If one child get two chikus, see here, if two chikus are given, given means एक child को तो two chikus मिलेगा. So if one child get two chikus, therefore nine children के लिए बात किए, तो therefore nine children get how many chikus? Nine multiply by two is equal to 9 multiply by 2. 9 2s are 18. 18 what? How many chikus? So, chikus. 18 chikus. Ab hume answer likhna hai. How many chikus are needed? So, 18 chikus are distributed among 9 children. Agar hum aise bhi likhe to chalega ki 18 chikus are needed to distribute among 9 children. Both are same. Both the way you can able to write. Now see the sixth one. First of all, read it. If 5 person can sit in one motor car. Ek motor car mein kitne person baith sakte hai? To 5 person. 5 person can sit in one motor car. Then, how many persons can sit in 7 such motor cars? वैसे 7 motor car है, उसमें कितने person बैठ सकेंगे? See, how you have to write down? In one motor car, 5 person can sit. एक motor car में 5 person बैठ सकते हैं. Therefore, in 7 motor cars, how many persons can sit? Okay. So, 7 multiply by 5, cross multiplication is equal to 7 multiply by 5. 7 5s are 35. So, 35 how many persons? So, 35 person. Therefore, answer mein aapko likhna hai, 35 person can sit in 7 motor cars. Now, next sum we will see in the next video. Stay safe, stay healthy. Okay, bye.